I have the privilege of introducing our next speaker because one of our graders couldn't make it today. So with that, a little background on that person. He was born and raised in Southern California, has lived in Huntington Beach his entire life. Not that he's old or anything, but he's like the entire life. He has three children and one wife, which is really the right way to do it. I mean, really, it's really the right way to do it. He's passionate about four things. One is his family. Two, snow skiing. Not necessarily in this order, but family, snow skiing, soccer, and riding motorcycles. He's been in his business for 25 years, even though that was a gut check for him when he had to tell me how many years he was in. He was like, oh, 25 years, can't believe that. And today, as promised, he's going to give us a demonstration of part of what he does for a living. Please welcome Ken Radzai, our flooring contractor.
Hello, everybody. Number one, can everyone hear me? A lot of times my voice doesn't carry.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks. And Jay's going to help me because I'm going to scoot this up over the table. It's going to be a little hard to see, so please, if you can't see, scoot closer. Okay, I'm going to show you some of the basic tools we're going to need to repair a tongue and groove wood floor.
Cool.
This is officially damaged by a 12-year-old boy.
Okay. An official 12-year-old.
Yes, officially damaged. You're going to need a circular saw. I brought a very simple, you don't need professional tools. You can do this very simply. You need a hammer, chisel, wood chisel, pry bar would help. What I'm going to do is, and then real quick, I'm going to pass out. This is the piece we're going to finally use for the replacement. I've cut off the part of the groove and the end tongue on the board. I'll give you another piece, give you an example of what one intact would look like. To get the tongue and groove floor back in, we have to alter it a little bit, or we can't get it. So, Jim, if you could pass that around. Appreciate it. Okay. I've got some pieces up here. What I'll do is I'm going to do a little flooring magic here real quick and change out this piece and show you what it will look like once you make your cuts into the damaged wood. So, that's not how it does. Hold on, Jay and I are going to, and please, if anyone has any questions while I'm doing this, please stop me. This was easier than actually making the noise with the saws today. I pre-cut it for you. Now done is we took our circular saw and you want to set your blade just deeper than your actual floor. Okay, you can whether this is on a it's a glue down floor or a nail down floor. If it's a nail down floor on wood, you can cut into the existing subfloor a little bit so it's not gonna hurt anything. If it's a glue down floor, you can cut into the glue a little bit. So you just set your saw just deeper than your the thickness of your floor. And how we do that, we're gonna make what we call a plunge cut. And we're gonna go right like this, trying not to damage the pieces on any of the other sides. We're just gonna zip along there, and do little plunge cuts on the end. Then what we do is we take our chisel, we're gonna, you can't cut all the way to the edge of the piece, you'll damage the next one in. So we're gonna take a chisel, and we're gonna hammer through very carefully the ends. Take our pry bar. We're gonna start to remove the pieces. Sometimes easier said than done. About ruining these pieces since it's already a damaged piece. Jay's my new apprentice.
That's good, right?
So Jay's will just fold that in there. Did someone say safety? See, I've got 10 minutes. I know this might look a little silly. But this will save you learning how to do this. My minimum charge is $500 for this.
Wow.
And this is something that you can definitely do by yourself. If it's a glue down floor, it's going to be, you know, a mess in there. You got to make sure and get all the glue off. But now we're ready to go. And you can do this whether it's, you know, one damaged piece, two or three. You just need to take out the full boards. Okay. Any questions so far?
No.
You sure?
We just call you first.
I'm the apprentice.
Okay.
Looking real good right now.
Yeah.
Who has our finished product, our finished piece? Is it almost coming around?
How did we determine that it was a nail down or a glue down?
Well, hopefully you were there when it went in. If not, you could... I'm trying to think how you guys could do it. One of the easiest ways, if you tap on the floor,
uh-huh.
If it's a glue down, it's really solid sounding.
Okay.
If you are on a raised foundation,
uh-huh.
There's a chance you could have a nail down floor. Any solid flooring will be a nail down.
Okay.
This is all engineered. If you look at the piece, you'll see the layers of wood on it. These are typically glued down. Thanks, sir. Now, did you guys understand the whole concept of cutting out the tongue and groove? Because it's hard to see again, but we have a tongue sticking out on this floor here. We have the tongue on this side and the groove on this side. What we're going to end up doing is getting this slide in like that. It's going to go. You're going to put the tongue into the groove so you still have part of the floor intact. And then basically that's it. Hey, yes, sir.
Now, how strong is that
Now, how strong is that now? Because cut the what the kind of root on one side is also.
Any repaired floor is not as good as the original, but one piece of wood, it could be a $10,000 floor. You know, this is the way to go.
He's a carpenter.
So you put back in on the side. You put
well, you would glue down. If it was a glue down floor, it'd be entire glue down over the whole thing.
What if it's a floater?
Well, floating floors are not as easy to repair. It's one of the reasons that we don't like to sell them as much as we do the traditional ways of putting them in. You can still do it. You would glue the tongue and groove and then just the one part of the groove, and you have to put it in like that. So once you're here, you have a new floor again. And if it was glued down, you just glue it, put some weight on it for 24 hours, and that floor's not going to go anywhere. You know, it's going to be fine for the rest of its life. If it was a nail down, you would have to tack it and then use some wood putty. But again, you know, it's either, I don't know if you guys can see this, but maybe pass that around. You know, either leave that in there or do this and get a new piece. Time's up. Jay, thank you very much.
All right.